So Jaffa, you said you give training to the tuk-tuk drivers, the rickshaw drivers.
Yeah, we have given, I can say, we have given a training program for the tuk-tuk drivers. The first time we have started with the Sri Lanka Tourism Authority and a Chamber Tourism. Because the tuk-tuk drivers, they are the people who give a real information about the country of the areas. A tourist we also like to go but tuk-tuk small in a different short destination. What Chamber Tourism did was we mediated and stage by stage. Initially, first stage we got 53 drivers, and we got a clearance from the police of the areas. We got an intelligent report from the state intelligence of Sri Lanka, intelligent report, and get the local authorities concerned. We get all approvals from them and get the final police report, and then we had exams. So after the 5 days exam, there will be out of 85, there are 53 selected. And we have given an identity card to them, by Sri Lanka Tourism Identity Card. So easy, if the ready tourists get into the three-wheel drivers, they can show the identity card, say they are tourism drivers. So without fear, tourists can go with them. They won't tell lies, they won't do any hassle, harassment, they won't do any sexual harassment to them, because they have been educated. Now, we wanted to expand that service to different area in the tourist destination. So even I met the Circle of Defense, I also made a suggestion with the tourism police. All the hoteliers, like Cinnamon, in front of Cinnamon Grand Hotel, in front of the railway station, in front of the bus stand, collect all the drivers, make them aware, give them a proper trainings, information. So what through that, they will have that, they will have the proper information. So people doesn't have tourists doesn't have any fear to go with them. So that program, if we are going on, if we also need more support to implement that. So that hope, if I have that type of thing, tourists will have more control. Also, we also mediate some training program for the youth in a hotel sectors, and we have full for 45 days training program. We did successful. Now all the boys are, and they got, now they are working in different place. So what we do, we try to get them more professional training. We are making how to speak in a language. Because we are different people are speaking different communities are living, they have different language. So we are always on educating them to have how they can professionally they can speak English and give them information to the people. And even some people doesn't know the now email, how to open the email. Some doesn't have an account of the email. So youth has now we in the rural area, we are now educating them. So now see, city between the city and the village is different totally. And you see, most of the village people never come to Colombo. If there are any exam, anything, any some only one case only they come, either hospital case or maybe go for a foreign country. So when people travel lot, they get experience. Now our people doesn't have experience because of the war. So because they were attempted house, they are cannot go they can't travel on the road. They are threatening on their life. So that was the situation we had more than 35 years. So now only the door has opened. So now we can, there's a way that this is the time to educate the communities and try to put them on a right track to go ahead their live programs. We have been UNWTO conference, we have mediated a lot of programs, especially in the eastern region. It's voluntarily mediated. So we need some sort of technical assistance, and important is that an exchange program where they must go and see other villages, other people. They must go and meet other people. Now in my village, people never come and stay at Kalam Cinnamon Hotel. Even then, I have a cup of tea, except 5%. So that has to come. We have to bring them some sort of way where they will have the changing of the mind. If you can make them a changing of the mind, definitely people there they can come up their life at least 50%. They can at least control their life. So you see how many people are going to meet this.
More than 1.5 million tourists, people are, local people, are Sri Lankan women are in overseas. Because why they are going? To get their incomes. At least they go for $100, $200. Why can't we make them to get the $100 here? Now if you see, you know, even for example, coconut cultivation in Sri Lanka is the third in the world to export market concern. So why is the difference? Now that we resource is available. So we, whereas I say, educating the people professionally is must. Anyway, that is the important, that is one thing, that is the concept that we need for our country, especially in the poor, in the rural villages area. The government of Sri Lanka, president is also doing mass work to improve the program. But you know, the infrastructure development concern, we are very satisfied. I hope we didn't see in the color city now. How is it? It's clean. City is getting beauty. So that aspiration has to go also to the village. I didn't say that town, that urban area has to become as a village. No. Village has to be a village. You must not make village as a city. But we want to have the village to have a service. They should have a good hospital, they should have operation theatres, they should have a good education schools, they should be having the road access, electricities. These are things that the village we should provide. We must not put big concrete building, and if you build concrete building, then you can't see after 10 years, there's no village you can't see in the countries. So my concept is village has to be a village, but make them service availabilities in such a way. So Chamber of Tourism will definitely, we are voluntarily helping in things, so we need international support to go ahead the other works.